Children, we go ahead to the next topic of this lesson, that is after February. Yes, it means after the February revolution that took place in Petrograd, and now it is March. Okay. Children, after the February revolution in Petrograd, things had changed. And as you know, the Tsar was forced to leave, and on 2nd of March he was abdicated, and the country was taken over by the provincial government. Now this provincial government was dominated by army officials, by landowners and by industrialists, but they were supported by the liberals and socialists also, and they did some good work. The restrictions on public meetings and associations were removed, and they also made Soviet the councils, you know, remember Soviet that was made, like the Petrograd Soviet, where both the soldiers and the peasants, you know, got together and formed a Soviet. So this kind of Soviet was set up everywhere in Russia. So this was a good work done by the liberals and socialists. What was it? Restrictions on public meeting and associations were removed, and Soviets were set up everywhere in Russia. Soviets, you know, meaning council, or a group of people or associations. Now children, in April, this leader Vladimir Lenin returns from exile. Now what do you mean? Where was he earlier? Exile. Now as you know, Russia was ruled by an autocrat ruler, Tsar Nicholas II, and during his time he had staged quite a lot of protests. So in order to avoid him, he had ordered his soldiers that he should not be seen in the country. So he went into hiding. And now when the Tsar was abdicated, he was no longer and was forced to leave, Lenin returns back to Russia. And the first thing he told the people, and he believed that now it was a time for these Soviets to take over charge and run the government. Soviets, you know, the councils that were made. Okay. Children, Lenin put forward three demands, and they were called as April Thesis. Now what were the three demands? Let's look into it. The first demand was that the war should end, the First World War should end, and they should not, Russia should not participate. Second was that the land that was owned by the nobility should be handed over to the peasants. So the transfer of lands should be given to the farmers or peasants. And the third one was to nationalize the banks. Like the banks were now private, they should come under the government. The government should look into the banks. So these were the three demands that he put forward. Let's recap it again. So transfer of land to peasants, and the first one was to end the war, which was called as the April Thesis. Children, he now wanted the change of name of his Bolshevik party to be called as Communist Party, because he believed in the ideas of Karl Marx. Now what was Karl Marx's idea? He believed in the principle of socialism. Socialism, as just recap again, is a society where the means of production are collectively owned by the government or by the workers, and whatever profit is earned, it is shared among all, and it will be working for the interest of the workers. So that was the principle of socialism, and that kind of, this principle is adopted, it would lead to what kind of a society? A communist society where there would be no class amongst people, and people will live in peace and harmony. So he wanted a party to be called as the Communist Party or communism, okay, where everything is shared among all. Children, then we see workers' movement, they're joining hands together and it is spreading. We see formation of trade unions in industrial areas. We see factory committees being formed in armies, soldier committees being formed. Now, seeing all this, the provincial government started feeling that their power is getting reduced and the power of the Bolshevik party is increasing. Now they had to do something to curtail this. So they took stern action, and they would arrest all these leaders, and if the demonstrations were taking place, they would suppress it. Okay. So they felt that their powers was decreasing, and Bolshevik party's powers increasing, which was leading to now a new form, a new phase called socialism was being now established in Russia. Children, now the leaders of the Bolshevik party also were surprised at Lenin's demand, because they felt that it was too early for the socialist movement and they must now support the provisional government. But later on, with certain developments, they also realized that the change was required and they were moving ahead to the socialist form of government. Countryside peasants and socialist revolutionary leaders also pressurized for redistribution of land among the peasants, the transfer of land to the peasants. And the peasants were encouraged by these socialist revolutionaries, and they finally, these peasants seized the land from the landowners between July and September 1917. So you can see here also, this is the countryside where they pressed for redistribution of land or transfer of land to the peasants. Recap now, whatever we have learnt after February in this topic, we see after the Tsar was removed, the provincial government was running Russia, took over the running of children. We'll just recap whatever we have learned so far on the topic after February. We see now the provincial government has taken over after the fall of the Tsar, and we see the socialists and the liberals also now helping the provincial government. Their restrictions on public meetings and associations were removed, and council or groups and associations like Soviet were established everywhere in Russia, like the Petrograd Soviet. And in factories also, committees were formed who began questioning the way these industrialists ran their factories. Even in the army, soldiers committee were formed. So everywhere unions were being formed, trade unions were being formed also. Then we see in April 1917, the Bolshevik leader Lenin returns from exile, and he believes that it's time for these council or the Soviets to take over power. And he gave the April thesis. There were three main points in this thesis: war should be brought to an end, land should be transferred to peasants, and banks should be nationalized. And he also wanted to rename the Bolshevik party to Communist Party on the ideas of Karl Marx. Now, members of his own party were surprised by this April thesis. They thought it was not the right time for the socialist government and must support the provincial government. But later, due to certain developments, their attitude changed. And finally, they thought, yes, now it's the right time to have a socialist or a communist form of government. Now, when the provincial government saw that its power was getting reduced and the Bolshevik influence grew, they were getting more powerful, they decided to take certain measures to suppress them. So they arrested their leaders, okay, and they would also, wherever they made demonstrations, it would be curbed. And in the countryside, we see now even the peasants, and along with the socialist revolutionary leaders, they pressurized the government for redistribution of land. And encouraged by these revolutionaries, the peasants now got seized the land from the landowners between July and September 1917. And then we continue with the further events in my next video.